Butler Countyans gathered at the square in Morgantown Friday night for the 2011 Relay for Life, with a goal of raising money for the American Cancer Society to help fund research to cure the disease. The night's activities included a survivor's recognition and survivor's walk, as well as fun activities for kids and adults alike. Relay teams provided local food, bouncy castles for youngsters, t-shirts, crafts, and silent basket auctions as fundraising activities. Relay co-chairs Becky Hankins and Kenna Martin spoke to the banner about their motivations in helping plan the event.
Becky, just tell us a little bit about Relay for Life and how you became to be involved in it.
Well, I started years ago with the Methodist Church. We would always have a team. And then I also relayed with Morgantown Elementary School. But then it became more personal. In 2007, I was diagnosed with breast cancer. So then it became a personal thing to me, and I want to raise money to help fund a cure for cancer.
Mm-hmm. Now, how long has Butler County been participating with the relay event?
We believe it started in 2000. It started out at the high school. They walked the track. They had quite a few teams. But this year we wanted to try something different to get the community involved, so we have brought it to the town square.
Mm-hmm. Now, Kenna, you're serving as co-chair with Becky this year. How long have you been involved with Relay, and what's your motivation?
I've been helping with the committee for the past 3 years, but I've been attending the Relay for, I know, 5 or 6 years. I relay actually in memory of my grandfather, Harold Embry, who passed away almost 3 years ago of cancer, and he actually took treatments with Becky.
We took treatments together.
So that's the reason why I do it. He's the first person in my family that I was close to that had cancer, and seeing what he went through, it was hard, mm-hmm. and I want to find a cure.
Now, Kenna, it seems it's a little bit different event this year. It's downtown. What are y'all hoping to see out of it moving downtown this year?
I hope we see maybe people that have never come to the relay before, just driving by and just kind of coming over to see what's happening. And maybe by just stopping by and expect it, they will pick up some facts about how American Cancer Society has helped people in their community. We've got an information table up here, so we're hoping that to not only raise money tonight, but raise awareness.
Becky, historically, how much money can we expect?
I think last year we made around $25,000. So we would love to make more than that, but with the economy, we know that that's a problem. We've raised about $13,000 already.
Yeah, it's a pretty good start.
We're tickled with that.
All right. Well, ladies, thank you for your work with the Relay for Life, and thank you for your time.
Thank you so much.
An illness, take a loved one from our home. You know, sometimes life just ain't fair. She made reservations, and I know where she's going. There's no cancer waiting there. As we gathered round her, we knew the time was near. We watched her slowly slip away. Such a peaceful feeling came into that room. And I can almost hear her say,
John is says there's no greater love than for a friend to lay his life down for another. Jesus Christ himself comes and laid his life down for us all. And if you belong to him, you have freedom beyond compare. And if you're free in the Lord, you are free indeed.
Despite a smaller-than-expected turnout, participants were enthusiastic as the night went on, playing games and competing while raising important cancer research funding. In addition to the fundraising, participants were also invited to sign an American Cancer Society banner to commemorate the evening and took away T-shirts declaring a commitment to beating cancer for good.
You wonderful.